Hey, a new phrase of the pandemic has emerged this week, and that is tourism testing. That is the stamp at COVID test sites across the news of the country as thousands seek negative results before travelling interstate.
Queensland has one of the toughest regulations, requiring a negative result up to 72 hours before arrival. But with so many results delayed, it's seen many people have to cancel their travel plans and holiday bookings altogether. Let's bring in Queensland Police Commissioner Katarina Carroll in Brisbane for us. Good morning to you, Commissioner. This rule is causing chaos to people's plans. Do you think you can relax it slightly in the last few days before Christmas?
So obviously those discussions are going to be had today, and I understand discussed at National Cabinet. However, they were put in place for a very good reason, and I know there's a lot of science attached to the 72 hours. And we at the end of the day have to enforce that directive. Unfortunately, some people have been turned away, and I know it's becoming, you know, a big issue for people coming into the state. But as I said, those discussions or further discussions will be had today about this issue.
But it's, you know, what are the situations like at the border and how are your officers coping? We know that yesterday they turned away hundreds of people.
So certainly since the 13th of this month, we've had over 235,000 GV applications for border passes, and GVs from those, you know, hot spots like Melbourne and Sydney. In the beginning, I've got to say, it was joyous seeing so many people coming to the state, and our officers really enjoyed seeing families come together. The numbers are quite enormous, but we have planned for that over an extended period of time. And while I'm on air, can I take an opportunity to give a big shout out to the Queensland Police? You know, it's been challenging for 2 years. We've kept the state safe, and really we're ready for the influx, and we certainly have been for some period of time.
Well, don't worry, we'll keep coming.
Oh yeah, they sure will. Another rule change, close contacts.
We're looking forward to it.
Another rule change, close contacts will now have to isolate for 7 days instead of 14. Why has that one changed?
Certainly, that's just part of the roadmap, and we were always anticipating that this was going to happen on the 1st of January. We reached 90% first dose yesterday, and the Chief Health Officer was very comfortable with changing that. For us, excellent. We had 100 police officers that are in quarantine as a result of, you know, close contact to COVID-19. In fact, 7 of our officers have COVID-19. Absolutely tremendous change, very supportive of it. Again, based on good evidence and science. All our officers are double vaccinated, so certainly it does apply to them. And yeah, so that changed yesterday. So very, very good, I think, for everyone coming into the state, but particularly for frontline workforce.
What about the renewed mask mandate that came into effect over the weekend? How are people abiding by those rules?
The compliance has been excellent, and we certainly find this in Queensland. There's been a number of fines we've issued, you know, throughout the last few days, but that's really been quite minor. We've handed out several hundred masks, in fact. So what we try and do is have a really educative approach to this, one of communication, compassion. And finally, if there's blatant disregard for the directive, you know, we will obviously enforce the directive. But certainly compliance has been pleasingly, you know, really, really great. And I ask the public to continue this, particularly as we have so many people coming from interstate. We know it is one of the, you know, safest things you can do in COVID to protect yourself and others. And it has been working extraordinarily well.
Hospitality and entertainment venues will have to enforce the vaccine mandates on their patrons. Are police on the ground seeing much resistance from businesses in regards to that?
So this has been taking place for about a week now since the new directive has come into place. Obviously, we prepared for it for many weeks, and the public and businesses and patrons knew this was happening for quite a few weeks. Again, the compliance has been exceptional. There have been a few businesses that have been blatantly disregarding the directive, and when we've explained, you know, the rules, the regulations, and we've even visited places with the public health, they have changed their mind and obviously are abiding by the directive, but some haven't. And obviously enforcement action has been, has been taken in that regard. But all in all, I've got to say across the entire state, the compliance has been extraordinarily high and extraordinarily pleasing.
Commissioner, just quickly, 7 Queensland officers tested positive to COVID-19, sending more than 100 into isolation. Is that going to put a lot of stress over your team coming into this holiday period?
So there was one small station where there were eight offices that was closed down and covered by a larger station. All our large stations are still open. The biggest, I think, positive thing about this is the change from the 14 days quarantine to seven. So a lot of those offices are actually coming out over the next day or so. Thankfully, those seven haven't had a severe case of disease. We are all double vaccinated, which is incredibly important for our workforce. But no, we've included that in our contingency planning, so I'm quite comfortable. For all of those people visiting from other states, welcome to Queensland. We're ready to go.
Well, listen, yeah. We're ready to come up there. I tell you what, keep those borders nice and open. I'll be up there in January. Commissioner, it's great to have you on the show. Stay safe and have a good Christmas.
Thank you.
There are concerns testing backlogs will impact Queensland's long-suffering tourism industry, with many travellers fearing they won't get their results in time. We're joined by Queensland Tourism Industry Council CEO Daniel Gershwind in Brisbane. Daniel, good to see you. Thousands will be flooding over to Queensland in the coming days. But, you know, there's this backlog that's been really delaying things here. Are you seeing bookings cancelled as a result of these testing delays?
Well, it's hard to say at the moment, David. We certainly seen big numbers coming into Queensland since the borders opened, and we're very grateful that the borders are finally open, that we have certainty that they will stay open. The Premier's been adamant about that, so that's very good news. But certainly the testing requirements, or more importantly, the delays in getting the test done before you travel, that is a concern to us, and it's not really encouraging people to book their holidays further down the track. So we do hope that we'll see a resolution to this situation, either a change in the requirement or certainly a boost to the availability of testing in all other states. So hopefully National Cabinet today will come up with a better solution and we'll see more confidence return to the travel market.
Yeah, we really need it, don't we? Queensland Health is considering relaxing entry requirements into the state. So is this the circuit breaker that is needed?
I think that's the next step, absolutely not. We had to be many steps to get out of this crisis and back to some normality in our tourism industry, but also for the community. So if we can find a solution to the testing requirement, that's a great step. We then need clarity about what constitutes a close contact, for instance. We've seen the very welcome reduction of quarantine requirements or isolation requirements for close contacts here in Queensland. That's great, from 14 days to 7 days. That helps not only travelers, but also, of course, staff that might be deemed close contacts. But we need that increasing certainty, increasing availability of the testing, as I said, and we need many steps to return to certainty. But we're on the path. We are optimistic about this Christmas season here in Queensland. We're optimistic that travellers will rebuild their confidence in being able to travel across borders in Australia. And that's certainly what we need to do for 2022.
Well, obviously, you're sounding very confident there, but, you know, we know how fast-spreading Omicron is. You had 61 cases yesterday. You know, after two tough years for Queensland tourism, can you guys hold your nerve, or is there a sense of uncertainty in the community?
Oh, look, the uncertainty is not surprisingly there after 2 years of this, both in the business community but also in the travelling public. So it will take some time to restore that, but we are more optimistic than we've been in a long while. We know that Omicron is posing a threat in terms of the spread at a more rapid rate than previous variants of this virus. But as we heard from the experts even this morning, the expectation is now that it doesn't make you as sick, certainly not if you're vaccinated. And that should give us the confidence that we can indeed live with it, which is what the politicians, including here in Queensland, have told us we have to do. And the confidence that also is returning to governments that they can actually manage this without wholesale lockdowns, without hotspot declarations for entire states, that gives us a bit of confidence that we are indeed moving towards living with the virus. Unfortunately, that's what the future will hold, but we can do this in a way that still allows us to travel, allows us to return to our families, and allows us to return to our lives.
Daniel, this, if you are fully vaccinated and a close contact, now you only have to quarantine for 7 days instead of 14 in Queensland. Does that help?
Oh, absolutely. Look, it was a great concern that not only families would suddenly be separated for 2 weeks and just before Christmas, that's a tragic outcome, but also it had very, very serious implications for our staffing. We already, in our industry across the country, are under pressure to find sufficient staff, and to have suddenly a staff quarantined for 14 days is fairly catastrophic for businesses. So at least a reduction to 7 days makes that a little bit easier. But we hope to have more clarity about who is a close contact, what is necessary to do, what can we do to minimize the risk of being a close contact. Is it wearing masks? Is it returning to some social distancing? Whatever we can do to minimize that risk is certainly something we'd be willing to do. Our industry has been extremely compliant, very willing to do the right thing to keep our travelers and our visitors safe and our staff. We will continue to do this, but we want to make sure that governments nationally also build their confidence and give us clarity of what's expected.
Well, all the eyes are on National Cabinet today, aren't they? Daniel Gershwin, we really do appreciate your time this morning.